Good morning, everyone. Welcome. And let's begin with our hymn of welcome, number 51, Lady of the Season's Laughter.
Lady of the Season's Laughter, in the summer warmth be near. When the winter follows after, teach our spirits not to fear. Hold us in your steady mercy, Lady of the turning year. Sister of the evening starlight, in the falling shadow stay. Here among us till the far light of tomorrow's dawning ray. Hold us in your steady mercy, Lady of the turning day. Mother of the generations, in whose love all life is worth, everlasting celebrations bring our labor safe to birth. Hold us in your steady mercy, Lady of the turning earth. Goddess of all time's progression, stand with us when we engage, hand and hearts to end oppression, writing history's fairer page. Hold us in your steady mercy, Lady of the turning age.
Good morning. My name is Bruni Edwards. I've been a member of this congregation since 2008. In the past, I have been on the board. I have been an RE teacher. I have coordinated a coffee hour, and currently I am the chair of the membership team. We are so glad that each of you are able to join us this morning. And together in community, we can ensure that social distancing does not mean social disengagement. Our weekly services are more than just a gathering of our physical bodies. It is the forming of a sacred time that we make together. Whether you are well-versed in technology or teleconferencing, or this is your first venture, we welcome you. For those of you new among us, or reconnecting with fonder hearts, we invite you to introduce yourselves and where you're connecting from in the chat box as you are comfortable. Whatever faith and traditions of your past, whatever your theological stance, whatever your heritage, whoever you are and whomever you love, we welcome you. You can learn more about us at our website and Facebook page. We encourage you to share our Facebook page, and reach out to others who may be isolated at this time and might benefit from a spiritual connection with our loving community. We have a few announcements today. You can look on the screen as well as I'll point out a few. You can join us after the service for our post-service breakout groups. If there is someone in the breakout group that you don't know, please use this opportunity to get to know each other a little bit better. And after 15 minutes, we'll come together and share some highlights from the smaller group. The Social Action Council has a meeting tonight at 7 p.m. via Zoom. If you want information about that, you can reach out to Margaret Henderson, and her email is posted right now. Also, starting next week, once a month, we will start up our Sunday Connections. That is a meeting that's hosted by either Reverend Heather or someone from the membership team. It's formerly what was called First Sunday Connection. It's an opportunity for newcomers to meet immediately after the service and ask questions about the congregation or Unitarian Universalism. Our first meeting is next Sunday, the 27th. Reverend Heather is hosting that one. And what will happen is at the very end of the service, there'll be a Zoom link in the chat box, and you will join Reverend Heather after the service in a different Zoom room. Our Friday Fun is starting up again with two events coming up. There are going to be Zoom play readings on October 23rd, directed by Tony DeFabio, and then another installation of our open mic night. This one is a Halloween edition, and that will occur on October 30th. Wear your costumes. And just a few reminders about our online service. So everyone is muted, that is just to optimize our speakers. You can control who you see in the webcam. You can look at speaker view or gallery view, and you may need to scroll down to see others. At times, text will show up on the screen like this, and at other times it'll be a video. If you're having issues with your technology, you can send a private chat to UU Congregation of Danbury, and Sherry will help you out. If you find the chat distracting, you can control it by minimizing it. Now is the time to join Gina Cassetta with our chalice lighting. So if you have a chalice, go ahead and grab it.
So I invite you to light your chalice and then join me in the chalice lighting affirmation. Love is the spirit of this congregation, and justice is its light. This is our covenant, to dwell together in peace, to seek and speak the truth in love, to help one another and celebrate life. And the opening words today are by Madeline Lingle, Epiphany. I cannot go back to night. O truth, O small and unexpected thing, you have taken so much from me. How can I bear wisdom's pain? But I have been shown, and I have seen. And I am actually a member of the Religious Education Ministry team. And the other members have prepared a video message for you today to share. And here are Kristen, Michelle, and Sierra Marie.
I'm Kristen Papucci, the Religious Education Ministry Team co-chair.
And I'm Michelle Cousins, the other Religious Education Ministry Team co-chair.
And I'm Sierra Marie Gerfeo, Director of Religious Education for Children and Youth. Any kids and teens out there, we hope you're watching.
It's such a joy to welcome you and your grown-ups to the 2020-21 year of religious education.
This year is a choose-your-own-adventure year in religious education. We know that no two kids and no two families are exactly alike.
Just the way adults get to choose how they participate at our Unitarian Universalist congregation, we want you to have the same opportunity.
Now, this doesn't mean that your grown-ups can't set some rules or tell you some things that you have to do, because those are just things that your family does.
But it does mean that you and your family are invited to answer some important questions together.
Here are some of those questions.
What things would help me and my family stay connected to the community that loves me at the Unitarian Universalist Congregation of Danbury?
What would help me feel supported and be cared for by friends in the congregation? What would help me support and care for friends in the congregation, both newcomers and oldcomers?
What are the ways that I learn and grow?
What helps me connect to what is most important?
What helps me live according to my values?
How do I want to make a difference in my congregation, the community, where we live, and the world?
Classes are one thing you can do some of the time, but they're not the only thing.
Every week you can attend the service. We already know that a lot of you do.
And starting on October 11th, after the service, we'll have a Zoom room just for kids and youth during coffee hour. We'll do a spiritual practice together, and then we'll go into breakout rooms by age groups to share joys and sorrows and hang out together.
Every month, your family will receive a calendar.
You will find different kinds of activities available each week.
On the first week of every month, we'll have classes and youth group meetings. Those will be the only weeks we won't meet during coffee hour.
On the second week of every month, we'll have opportunities for connection.
On the third week of every month, we'll have creative projects.
On the fourth week of every month, we'll do things to care for our congregation, our communities, or our world.
And in months that have a fifth Sunday,
the high school youth will be able to coach or share with younger kids about some of their passions or interests by hosting a workshop.
So that's the five C's. First week, classes. Second week, connections. Third week, creativity. Fourth week, caring. And fifth week, coaching.
And by the way, you can be a religious education volunteer.
Yes, you who are children and youth, we are talking to you.
You can tell stories in the service.
Or illustrate or make animation or claymation to illustrate the stories we tell.
Or lead the children's affirmation in the service.
If you are a teen, you can lead a workshop for younger kids.
Or you can write a social justice column by youth for the comment.
And your grown-ups and families will have some options, too.
We'll send home materials every month with some ideas for things that your family can do together at home.
Parents of children age 0 to 6 can participate in a learning group called POP, or Parents of Preschoolers.
And parents of kids and teens of any age are invited to participate in a covenant group that will meet monthly.
Most of the things we do will be organized by a monthly spiritual theme.
You could say we're trying out a form of family ministry.
Or you could say that we're trying a multimodal or a multiple pathway approach to religious education.
But most of all, we hope you call it fun.
And if you're an adult who's listening and think this sounds great, there are ways for you to get involved.
We have one-time, short-term, and longer-term opportunities. We have opportunities to get involved for those of you who are the life of the party and those of you who are good behind-the-scenes support team members.
You can even join us on the Religious Education Ministry team.
Yep, looks like we've got some seats open here.
Welcome all to another year in religious education at the Unitarian Universalist Congregation of Danbury.
We are Unitarian Universalists. We are people with open minds, loving hearts, and helping hands.
And I would like to remind everyone that if you have cut up an apple and you've got your honey nearby, this is the time to go get it. And Nancy Hershatter will be doing the time for all ages.
Good morning, everyone. L'Shana Tova. Happy New Year. If you have friends or loved ones who are Jewish, or Junitarian, you may have heard this greeting this past couple of days and wondered, why are they wishing each other a Happy New Year in September? Well, on the Hebrew calendar, they started counting a long, long time ago, almost 6,000 years. So this new year about to begin is 5781. And the year is counted from September to September instead of January 1st to December 31st. And instead of dropping a ball from some tall building on New Year's Eve, the rabbi in the synagogue or shul is the Yiddish word for a synagogue, places a long, slender ram's horn to his lips, or her lips, and blows three patterns of sound, Tekiya, Shevarim, and Teruah. Wake up! Listen! A warning and a welcome, and an invitation to go within and examine our deeds and our connections to each other and to our higher purpose. And then we dip apple slices in honey to wish one another a sweet new year. If you have apples and honey handy, I invite you to do that now. Take a slice of apple, dip it in the honey, and have a taste. You can also do it later. Now, the song I'm about to sing with you borrows the tune from a patriotic American song that everyone will recognize. The words are going to be on your screen, and the tune is... You know it. Not a traditional Hebrew tune at all. So that's... In Shul on Rosh Hashanah in September every year, the rabbi blows the shofar and the sound is sweet and clear. She lifts the ram's horn to her lips so everyone can hear for a joyful, sweet new year. I know I can't hear you, but pretend I can. The nice thing about Zoom is you can sing out of tune and nobody will know. Hear the blowing of the shofar. Hear the blowing of the shofar. Hear the blowing of the shofar. For a joyful, sweet new year. Then we go to the orchard, pick some apples with a crunch. We'll pile them in the basket till we got a great big bunch. We'll take them home, make apple pie, and save some for our lunch, for a joyful, sweet new year. Let me hear you. Pretend I can hear you. Dip the apples in the honey. Dip the apples in the honey. Dip the apples in the honey, for a joyful, sweet new year. L'shana tova. Happy New Year to all of you.
All right, I'll try that. Rosh Hashanah literally means the head of the year, and it's the Jewish New Year, as Nancy just told us. It is a time of inner renewal and divine atonement, meaning it is both a time of rejoicing as well as a time for serious introspection. A shofar is a ram's horn that is blown like a trumpet during the Rosh Hashanah services every day except on Shabbat. The sounds of the shofar, which you will hear at the beginning and end of the next video, remind many people of a crying voice. Hearing the shofar's call is a reminder for us to look inward and repent for any sins of the past year. Hebrew scholar M.M. Kalish, on the other hand, states that the loud notes were meant to rouse God's mercy in the people's favor so that he would remember his people and grant them his blessing and protection in the coming year. The lyrics of the Hebrew song, Avinu Malkeinu, which was played at the very beginning of the service, that Barbara Streisand sang, is a pleading for mercy. And it translates as, Our Father, our King, hear our voice. We have sinned against you. Our Father, our King, have compassion upon us and upon our children. Our Father, our King, bring an end to pestilence, war, and famine around us. Our Father, our King, bring an end to all trouble and oppression around us. our Father, our King, renew upon us a good year. Hear our voice. The cry to be heard reminded me of the many marches this year for structural societal reform, taking the form of street protests. It may feel we are not being heard, and so it requires us to look within. If you turn the shofar on its side, it looks like a question mark, and its blast draws our attention to the most important questions we can ask ourselves. We'll get to some of those. In the wake of all the hurricanes, the tornadoes, and the violence that have been so prevalent lately in our country, I invite you to consider that the pagan rites consider water as a symbol for our emotion, which may need to be expressed and purged at this time. The best description of this process I found comes from the 78th stanza of the Tao Te Ching. Under heaven, nothing is more soft and yielding than water. Yet for attacking the solid and the strong, nothing is better. It has no equal. The weak can overcome the strong. The supple can overcome the stiff. Under heaven, everyone knows this. Yet no one puts it into practice. Therefore, the sage says, he who takes upon himself the humiliation of the people is fit to rule them. He who takes upon himself the country's disasters deserves to be king of the universe. The truth often sounds paradoxical. And now it's a time for meditation. So I invite you to take a few deep breaths to quiet your mind. Ask yourself what you need now. Are there emotions asking to be expressed? And what in your life can use a reset? So ponder those questions silently as you breathe in and out. And Jerry will play the Spirit of Life to bring us out of meditation.
Spirit of life,
we have a time for milestones, I would like to say a word to remember Ruth Bader Ginsburg and her invincible strength and intellect. First, in becoming an attorney when women were not welcomed into law school, then rising in her career to become a Supreme Court judge, and finally, her long battle for health. May her spirit of service, equality, and justice remain as an inspiration in the hearts of all the Supreme Court judges and the decisions they make. Feel free to share your reflections and milestones during the soft music, and then we will watch a video and listen to a song for the new year sung by communities around the world.
Of renewal.
Hear that. That is the sound of repair.
How does the new year call you? What gives you pride and regret?
Do you hear that? This is how we reset.
Up. It's time to search my deeds.
Where have I stumbled? How can I redirect?
My book's sitting open. That's how I reset. Oh,
Consider what we are grateful for, and autumn is a time of harvesting what we have planted in the spring. Let us consider the lessons we have learned during this unusual year. Perhaps COVID-19 has made you more acutely aware of your need for community. Perhaps you spent more time out in nature or with your children. Maybe you read more books or took an online course in a subject you've been wanting to study for a long time. Or learn to make homemade sourdough bread with Jim Russell via Zoom? How have you reset? Perhaps you learned that you do not like wearing masks. Did you then also pause to consider if you wear any invisible masks? Are there parts of yourself you are too shy or afraid to show others? Perhaps this year has made you more keenly aware of the injustices in our society and prompted you to look inwards at your own attitudes or prejudices, or to become actively involved in changing the systems that are complicit to racial inequity and violence. Maybe you had time to reconsider the value of the hospital aide, the janitor, the UPS worker, the Dunkin' Donuts drive-thru person. Just maybe you wondered why the frontline people exposed to others' germs are paid so little, and how come the top executives who are safely working from home are paid enormous salaries. Or perhaps you are one of the healthcare workers feeling exhausted and learning new ways to self-care. Consider for a moment, what ways have you grown this year? And what are you grateful for? And we have a responsive reading now. I will read the minister's parts and Anya will read your part, the congregation's part. It's called A Harvest of Gratitude. Once more, the fields have ripened to harvest and the fruitful earth has fulfilled the promise of spring.
The work of those who labor has been rewarded. They have sown and reaped, planted and gathered.
How rich and beautiful is the bounty gathered, the golden grain and clustered corn, the grapes of purple and green,
the crimson apples and yellow pears, and all the colors of orchard and garden, vineyard and field.
Season follows after season. After winter, the spring, after summer, the harvest-laden autumn.
From bud to blossom, from flower to fruit, from seed to bud again, the beauty of earth unfolds.
From the harvest of the soil, we are given occasion to garner a harvest of the heart and the mind.
A harvest of resolve to be careful stewards of all life's gifts and opportunities.
A harvest of reverence for the wondrous power and life at work in things that grow and in the soul.
A harvest of gratitude for every good which we enjoy and of fellowship for all who are sustained by Earth's beauty.
And that was by Percival Chubb. I invite you now to support the Unitarian Universalist community of Danbury if you are grateful to have had this community. And Michelle will read the directions for this, for the offering.
Thank you, Gina. Good morning. I'm Michelle Cousins, and I'm the co-chair of the REMT this year. And it's my pleasure to share this gorgeous morning with you and to be involved in this beautiful service that Gina's put together for us. It's now time for our congregational offering. And if you're with us for the first time, please feel free to pass the virtual plate because your presence here in the Zoom room is your gift to us. Members, please click on the link of your screen to make a donation or pledge, for even though we are not in our beloved fellowship hall, our expenses for operating are still the same. You can also send a check to UUCD at our address at 24 Clapboard Ridge Road in Danbury, and we thank you for doing your part to support and sustain this community that we love. And now if you'll join with me in our congregational response. In the spirit of compassion and service, we dedicate these, our offerings.
And now Nancy Hershatter will teach us a song in Hebrew. It's in English, it's soon the day will arrive when we can be together, but she's offered to sing it and play it in a beautiful key for us.
Thank you, Gina. Thank you. I only see the top of my head. I better fix that. Okay, better. So I'm gonna teach you the chorus because it's really pretty easy. Can you repeat after me? Ode Tirei. Ode Tirei. Kama Tov. Yiye. Bashana. Bashana. Haba'a. And if you know soon the day will arrive, the melody is exactly the same. Ode Tirei. Ode Tirei. Kama Tov. Bashana, bashana, hava'a. O tirei, o tirei, kama tov yiye. Bashana, bashana, hava'a. And the word for word translation is on the left, and the Hebrew words on the right. I will just do the first verse in the interest of time. Bashana, hava'a. Mishav Ahamir Peset Venispor Tzipurim Nodedot Yaladim Bechufsha Yisachahu Tofeset abide, me hasado. O tire, help me. O tire, o tire, namatubie, mashana, mashana, ava, o tire, o tire, namatubie, mashana, mashana, ava.
Thank you, Nancy. That's got to be the easiest Hebrew song I've ever sung, at least the chorus part. Likewise, a new year can be a time for inspiring us to reset, make a fresh start. We might decide we will be better at keeping in touch with our family, perhaps exercise more, eat more vegetables, or spend more time in meditation or contemplation. We can dream about what we will do once or if life ever gets back to normal. Will we hug our parents more? Will we appreciate our friends more? Live more simply? Never take human touch for granted again? Continue to grow our own herbs or food? Be a better steward for nature? My humble suggestions are for us to be sure we are taking care of our own needs so that we come from a balanced place, to consider listening to our gut instinct a bit more rather than buying into the rhetoric of fear that the media is offering us, and to strive to remain curious about others' attitudes and to ask questions instead of being judgmental from the start. Here's a reading by W.E.B. Du Bois. Now is the accepted time, not tomorrow, not some more convenient season. It is today that our best work can be done, and not some future day or year. It is today that we fit ourselves for the greater usefulness of tomorrow. Today is the seed time. Now are the hours of work, and tomorrow comes the harvest and the playtime. At the conclusion of the service, when we break out into chat rooms for sharing, I invite you to discuss behavioral changes or things you'd like to do once COVID-19 is a memory. Can you cultivate any of those seeds now? Join Nancy Hershatter for extinguishing the chalice.
Join me in extinguishing the chalice with these words. We extinguish this flame, but not the light of truth, the warmth of community, or the fire of commitment. These we carry in our hearts and out into the world until we are together again.
The closing hymn I chose because the words felt very poignant to me during the coronavirus pandemic. It mentions loss, the need to be still and reflect, and also the need for community. And the third verse especially talks about being able to strip away our masks someday and healing. Please join Jerry in singing number 340, Though Gathered Here to Celebrate.
Though gathered here to celebrate, my spirit's burning low. Instead of serving, now I wait the breath of worship's not too late. Breathe, let the embers glow. There have been losses on the way, a parent, partner, friend. At times I need to grieve and say, I have enough to bear today. Be near and help me mend. The stillness strips the mask away, exposes lonely hearts. Self-pity must not have its way. I'll live my life from day to day. And now the healing starts.
For the closing blessing, may you find ways to reset any attitudes or behaviors that do not bring you peace of mind. May you be grateful for the small ways in which this year has offered you blessings. And like the traditional apples dipped in honey, may this new cycle offer you sweetness in life. Thank you. And Jerry will now sing the Prayer of St. Francis, which is a prayer for peace.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. There is injury or pardon, Lord, and where there's doubt, true faith in you. O Master, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved and to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. Where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me an instrument of peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.